The topic of this paper was cholestatic liver disease. And bile is one of the most toxic fluids in our body, which is normally formed by hepatocytes in the liver and then secreted to the biliary tree, which collect in the gallbladder and finally drain to the intestinal tract. And if for any reason the bile cannot flow from the liver to the intestinal tract, this leads to bile retention in the liver, which is called cholestasis. And during the pathogenesis of cholestatic liver disease, clusters of dead cell areas are formed in the liver, which are called bile infarcts. And the formation of these bile infarcts in the liver in patients with cholestatic liver disease are known to be formed since many, many years. However, the exact mechanism how these bile infarcts are formed was not known. And this was the focus of our paper. We want to investigate the link between bile retention in the liver and the formation of bile infarcts in the parenchyma. A central technique in this study was intravital imaging, and for this we use a two-photon microscope. And with this technique, one can record the biological events and the biological functions in a real time and in a living liver. For example, here we see the structure of a mouse liver under the two-photon microscope. In red here, we see the sheets of hepatocyte, which are the major cell type of the liver. We see the nucleus in blue. And these black lines are the blood sinusoids in which the blood is flowing. And if we inject a green fluorescent bile salt now, we see that it first appears in the blood, and then it is transported to the hepatocyte, and finally it is secreted to the bile canaliculi. And after some time, the bile canaliculi will also get rid of this toxic bile salt, meaning that it's already excreted to the intestinal tract. Now we want to see what happened in case of cholestasis. How these bile canaliculi will get rid of this toxic bile salt. And to do this, we induced obstructive cholestasis in experimental animals. So this is a cholestatic mouse liver. Please focus on these bile canaliculi and this cell. So we see that all the bile canaliculi, they are overloaded with bile salt now. Now we see a rupture of these bile canaliculi and regurgitation of bile into the neighboring hepatocyte. And very important, this hepatocyte is releasing bile back to the blood. So it seems that these dead hepatocytes, during the acute stage of cholestasis, they serve as a shunt or a channel between the biliary tree and the blood in order to decrease the toxic concentration of bile salt in the liver. Next, we want to investigate how the release of bile by these dead hepatocytes will affect the neighboring cells. So now we focus in these green hepatocytes, which are overloaded with bile salts. And interestingly, we found a domino effect in which further killing events are stimulated. So it starts with one single hepatocyte, which is overloaded with bile salt, and then it stimulates killing of the neighboring cell and so on, until we have a large dead cell area. And all these hepatocytes, they are releasing bile back to the blood in order to decrease the toxic concentration of bile salt in the liver. And to kill a limited number of hepatocytes in the liver, this is not a big issue because the liver has a very high regeneration capacity, and this can be regenerated within days after this acute stage has been subsided. So now we learn how the bile infarcts are formed. So it starts with one single hepatocyte, and then it stimulates the killing of the neighboring cells until a large dead cell area is formed. So we learn now that the liver tries to protect itself by killing a limited number of hepatocytes. And these hepatocytes, they release the bile to the blood in order to decrease the concentration of bile salt in the liver. However, this leads to sharp elevation of the toxic bile salt in the blood. And this, of course, will be a challenge to the other body organs in our body. And now we want to investigate how this toxic bile salt will affect the other body organs, and we will focus especially on the kidney because this is the major excretory organ in our body. My name is Ahmed Ghallab. I'm a junior group leader at IfADo, working in the field of liver injury and regeneration and focusing mainly in intravital imaging.